Hello everyone, this is Light Shadow, and today I'm going to be showing you how to automatically send dusts from the chests in your cargo system that are holding the various dusts and stuff like all that straight into chests nearby that will hold them. And I'm going to show you how to do it with only one input node necessary. So yeah, let's get to it. I got the supplies with me. Might have enough connector nodes that I can make more if needed later in the video. So I have the one input. You're gonna need 9 output, 18 cargo motors, and 18 cobalt ingots for this. So we're gonna go to this nice auto crafting chamber right here and make some advanced output nodes. Just like that. See? Advanced ones. These ones have a really, really nice function, in which I'll show you in just a little bit. Right after I make this last one. So let me go down here and make it real quick. And there we go. They're pretty easy to make. Or at least easy to me. Anyway. So we're gonna take this input node, and we're gonna have to make sure it's on the cargo system on that node. So I'm gonna set up to just be on the one chest for now. And let's see, I'm pretty sure channel 16 is available, so I'll just use that. So we're gonna grab one of each type of dust real quick, and since we have this dust chest, we can just grab it from here. Here, since it's convenient. Just one of each, if I can find them all. Let's see, that's the lead, that's the silver, and that's the magnesium. Okay, so going to put one of each into here, and then you're gonna need, well, now that I think about it, another one of each. So you're gonna want to have two of each dust available before you do this. It's okay. But yeah, probably should have prepped that before this, but oh well. Lesson learned, all that. Anyway, so once you have some of each, you just need to take note of first where your storage is going to be. So first we're going to notice that the cargo manager goes right there. I'm going to break that block so I'll... and that block so that I can find it when I come up here. Yeah, it's right there, that's about typical. So we're gonna put a connector there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we'll just put one here, and then these are gonna be awesome. Okay, let's see, we're gonna have it going into this aluminum chest, so let's break this sign so that it can be used. So we're going to put our output right there, put it on channel 16, let's see, where's our aluminum dust, there it is. And now I'll just put aluminum dust in there automatically. And let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can do the same with our copper dust, and we'll have another connector here after I break this sign. So just like that, because we want all of them connected. So as you can see, these advanced output nodes are amazing because you can decide exactly what they're going to get from that channel. So we're going to put copper dust there. So that's aluminum and copper dust now. As you can see, it's already starting to get the copper dust. And then, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And yeah, I have so much gold dust already. Okay, 1 second. Let me break that. There we go. Let's see, I'm pretty sure this one's empty. Yep. So I'm gonna set that up. Just like so. And just gotta keep them all on channel 16, and you're just gonna decide which dust it's gonna accept. Which I'd consider pretty awesome. But yeah, just gonna keep doing that, just make sure they're all connected to the system. Alright. But yeah, it's really simple. As you can see, there's already dust going into those. And let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just keep track of where your connectors are, or because you want to make sure that you can actually get all the dust. Alright? Because otherwise it's going to be problematic. And let's see, there we go. One, two, three, four, five. Let's see, there we go, there we go. But yeah, it's really nice and simple, actually. And let's see, with the tin, I'm gonna use the spare chest next to it. Just because of how it's set up, or I can do that, yeah. Let's see. And then I just need to set it up for the lead and the, yeah, and the zinc. Wait, did I pass by the lead? Yes, I did. Whoops. One second. Let me break this one. And break that. I knew I was missing something. There we go. Okay, so we can add that in. But yeah, this is gonna make it so that all of your dusts are completely automatically going to their chests and you don't have to make some really annoying big elaborate system of some kind. Which I've had to do in the past before I found out about this being a thing. So yeah. You can set it up real nice so that it'll work out wonderfully. Let's see, there we go, that's gonna be the last one. So yeah, it's always awesome when you can set it up nicely with cargo management like this. Because there we go, and now that's going to be filling up. Yep. And there we go, now they're going to go into all of them. Now you can make it a lot more neat and orderly, it's just like this for my personal storage area. For me and a few of my friends. So yeah, that's how you set it up so that I can automatically get your dusts out of the chest and send them elsewhere. See, that chest is empty, so we can just get all the dust out of here. And this also means I have a couple extra output nodes now. So I can use that for a different project. But yeah, as you can see, it's going to work on grabbing the dust out of here. And yeah, so I can just put a various dust sign on there, and now you're only going to need one chest for the various dust that'll be coming from your machine, and they'll all get sent and to the appropriate chest. Just like that. As you can see, it's already grabbing them. So, yeah, that's how it works. Thanks for watching this video, everybody. If you have any suggestions, leave them in the comments below for stuff you want me to do. And, well, yeah, leave a like and subscribe for more videos and stuff. Thanks, everyone. Bye.